Hare Krishna. If we eat waste, it shows in our waste. We all need food for survival, but some food furthers our survival and some food takes us further away from survival. Sometimes we eat food that actually impedes our health rather than improving our health. And nowadays there's a lot of waste food that is available, that is just empty calories, that is just empty, there's too much fat, too much oil, too much sweet. And such food, it is waste in the sense that it is a waste of money for us to get that food, then it is a waste of energy for us to digest that food, and then it is a waste of effort for us to store that food. It is like we are carrying an empty tire around us, carrying a tire around us at our belly or elsewhere. Now, so if we eat waste, it shows in our waste. Our waistline grows bigger and bigger, and thus we end up obese, we end up de-energized, we end up unable to function as effectively as we could have. No wonder the Bhagavad-Gita recommends in 6.17 that we be regulated in our eating. It says in the previous verse that we cannot connect and contribute effectively if we eat too much, if we go to extremes in eating. Natyashnatustu yogosti na chaikantam anashnataha na chati swapna shilasya jagrato naiva charjuna. So here it's significant that what Krishna is saying is in the Gita that a regulated eating will not only maintain our bodily health, but it will also contribute to our spiritual health. If we are regulated in our eating, regulation at the material level will facilitate connection at the spiritual level. Because when there is regulation at the physical level, then minimum amount of attention and consciousness is spent at the physical level, and then maximum consciousness is available for the spiritual level, for our growth, for appreciating and relishing spirituality. So thus, by regulating our eating, we can further our all-round well-being, physical, material and spiritual. Thank you. Hare Krishna.